Indeed, hope and heartily praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
Praise the Lord, everyone.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
We thank the Lord that He has blessed us to be again in the house of the Lord. Thank the Lord for each and every one of you that have gathered in this house. Thank the Lord that our deacon has returned.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
From the Spanish speaking country.
Yes.
Thank you, Jesus. I don't know if you've been hoping at home or not. But we thank the Lord for all of you. And thank the Lord for our deacon who was here.
Amen.
And his poke.
Amen.
Has been very much on duty. Let's go to Hosea 6 for our scripture reading. If you've got it, say amen.
Amen.
Come and let us return unto the Lord. For he hath torn and he will heal us. He has smitten and he will bind us up.
After 2 days he will revive us. On the third day he will raise us up, and we shall live in his sight.
Then shall we know, if we follow on to know the Lord, his going forth is prepared as the morning, and he shall come unto us as the rain, as the latter and former rain unto the earth.
O Ephraim, what shall I do unto thee? O Judah, what shall I do unto thee? For your goodness is as the morning cloud, and as the early dew in the land.
Therefore have I hewed them by the prophets, I have slain them by the words of my mouth, and thy judgments are as the light that goeth forth.
But I desire mercy and not sacrifice, and the knowledge of God more than burnt offerings.
But they, like men, have transgressed the covenant. There have they dealt treacherously against me.
Gilead is a city of them that work iniquity, and is polluted with blood.
And as troops of robbers wait for a man, so the company of priests murder in the way by consent, for they commit lewdness.
I have seen a horrible thing in the house of Israel.
There's a horn of Ephraim.
Israel is defiled.
Together. Also, O Judah, he has set an harvest for thee when I return the captivity of my people. Heavenly Father, we are grateful and thankful for your kindness unto us, and allowing us to return again to the house of the Lord, and for your grace and tender mercies that have kept us day by day. Lord, we know that there is none other God but thee. You have brought us from darkness even into this marvelous light. You have kept us, Lord, with a mind that is stayed on thee. And we love you this evening. Help us, Lord, to reach into thy word. Give us understanding. Give us grace and knowledge, in Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Praise the Lord, everyone.
Praise the Lord.
We are thankful to the Lord for his kindness unto us, that he has blessed us to enter into the house of the Lord one more time and to call upon his name, knowing that he alone is God, and beside him there is none else. All the power and glory belongeth unto him. Thus I come. I like the Psalm 47, I think it is. Let me make sure. 47 says, then said I, lo, I come in the volume of the book, it is written of me. Amen? Do you understand that? He is saying that in the fullness, the completeness of the book, from Genesis to Revelation, this book is about Jesus.
Hallelujah.
It's about him and him alone. There are incidental characters for him to present his word and to make it make it so that we can receive and understand. But the book is not about David. It's not about Mary.
Thank you, Jesus.
It's not about me.
All right.
It's about Jesus.
All right,
now. Now, it's about us. Only because we are what? We are the body of Christ. And we are members in particular. Now, I've been trying to get this book together. Maybe I need to come down here with my secretaries and answer questions that they may have, that they may bring it together. But as a prelude in the book, I wanted to strike out and make acknowledgement about how I come to the understanding, how God led me to the knowledge that I have. Many of you saints want to know what Bishop Hope knows. Amen? How many of you want to know as much as I know? And we got one that's honest. Now, it may seem like that's a lot, but you'll find that it's not a lot. But she's only hit the second decade of her life. Bishop Hope has hit the 70th decade. He's in the 70th decade and soon reached the 80th. Decade of his life. So it is time and chance, but you must present yourself. You can't say, I want to be a doctor and not go to school. How many of you all want a doctor that didn't attend the university, there it is.
Some of them didn't.
How would you like a 10-year-old doctor? You wouldn't want it, right? Why is that? You know he has not been here long enough. Now, just because she's in her second decade doesn't mean that she can't know, because God can give it to whomever he chooses to give it. And if you're willing to put your mind to it, God just may give it to you. Deacon Holloway.
I'd like to make a comment on what you said.
I can't hear you.
I'd like to make a comment to something you said when you said how many were like a doctor that didn't go to school. But I have something, and it says, and I don't know, we got two teachers in here, and they might can attest to this. It's the 70, it's 70, 20, 10, and what it says is, it's a your learning abilities, 70% of your learning comes through experience, 20% comes through relationship, and only 10% comes through classroom and training and seminaries.
Okay, in school and seminary, they are...
You only gain 10% of your knowledge from that.
Yeah, that's how come they have hands-on experiences.
Even in school.
I know Wayne State, their doctors used to be at Harper Hospital. If they're still there, I don't know.
They rotate.
And there's some that's at Ford Hospital. And in these, they get a hands-on experience along with classroom experience. It helped to have classroom and all the experiences that you can obtain. It's good. It's good. Get as much experience as you can. That's how come a lot of times I speak to the saints that when they go into a service, go in there with their ears open, no matter how high the spirit is, you can rejoice, but your ears can still stay open. Amen? Because there is a lot to be learned, but you got to keep your eyes, ears open with your mouth shut. Hebrews. God gave me what I have through the experience of being in Bible class. Not only in Bishop District Elder Hoke's Bible class, but many Bible classes in different places across the country where we had conventions or we had councils. I got it from different bishops in their teaching. And each one of them have their own manner of teaching, their own way of explaining what they believe. As I said, one bishop said to me that David was going to sit on the throne in Jerusalem. And I said, David? He said, yeah. I'm pretty sure I said, David the patriarch? And he said, yes, David the patriarch is going to sit on the throne in the millennium. But I choose to differ it with the bishop. I choose to differ with the bishop on his conclusion. I did not give him an argument of his summation and what he believed, but I'm of a different mind as to who shall be on the throne. For Matthew 25 and 31, if you will turn there just for the moment, because I was speaking there. And the 31st verse, Sister Hoke, if you have it.
When the Son of Man
when the Son of Man, and we know that that is Jesus,
shall come in his glory.
Shall come in his glory, and in his glory is in his power. Read.
And all the holy angels with
him. And all the holy angels with him. Listen to what it says.
Then shall he sit upon the throne of his glory.
Shall he sit upon the throne of his glory. And that is the throne in Jerusalem. He will sit upon that throne in Jerusalem. That's the throne of his glory. It was supposed to be, well, it is, he promised David there shall not fail one to sit on his throne. And certainly there's not one that's failed to sit on the throne because Jesus didn't fail. Amen? Yeah. Hebrews 1:1, Sister Hope.
God,
who at sundry times,
and in divers manners,
spake in time past,
unto the fathers,
by the prophets, God has always spoken by men that he had chosen. In this case, he spoke to the prophets. Today, he is speaking to the ministers, the pastors, to promote salvation to his people. Read.
Hath in these last days,
spoken unto us
by his son.
Now, who is his son? Church. Who said that? Me. I didn't hear.
The church.
Who said that? That was you? That's good. Spoken unto us by his son. Why is she right? It says, we are what? And we are the what? The body, not bodies. But we are the body of Christ. Members what? In particular. Read.
Hath in these last days spoken unto us.
As hath in these last days spoken unto us
by his son, whom he hath appointed heir of all things, by whom also he made the world.
So it's under there a long time. Mm-hmm. Amen. It didn't start in Bethlehem of Judea. That's where he was born. Jesus is what? From everlasting to everlasting. And from everlasting to everlasting has no beginning. And it what? It has no end. Read.
Who being in the brightness of his glory.
And the express image
of his person,
and upholding all things
by the word of his power,
when he had by himself
purged our sins. Set down on the right hand of the majesty on high.
is, he sat on the right hand, or as it is, he sat in the power. He is the power. He didn't sit on the right side. He sat in the power of his majesty. And all shall see him in his majesty. Come on, say, when I get to heaven, I ain't looking for mama. I hope mama's there. I ain't looking for daddy. I hope daddy's there. I ain't looking for my sisters and my brothers. I'm looking for one. Who are you looking for? I'm looking for Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
All them other ones might be in the wrong places.
If you get to heaven, how you gonna miss Jesus?
Pardon?
If you make it to heaven, how you gonna miss seeing Jesus?
I don't plan to miss seeing him. But I'm saying, when I get to heaven, there's no chance that I'm going to miss seeing him when I get there. No. But when I get to heaven, folks say, when I get to heaven and I see my own mother again, your mother might not be there. I see my dad, your daddy might not be there. Now, I hope my daddy and my mama are there. They taught me truth. I believe they made it. Are you listening to me?
Mm-hmm.
But that's not who I'm going to heaven to see. That's all I'm saying, D. I'm not going to heaven to see mom. I'm not going to heaven to see dad. I'm going to heaven to see Jesus. In fact, I want to see him, and when I meet him in the sky, I want to be one of them flying right next to him.
All right.
Are you listening to me?
Amen.
Read, Sister Hope.
Being made so much better than
the angels.
As he hath by inheritance.
As he hath by inheritance
obtained a more excellent name
than they. What's his name?
Jesus.
Where did he get that name from?
It's always his name.
Where did he get it from? He said, I come what?
In my Father's name.
Where did he get his name from?
His Father.
Amen. Amen. He has an excellent name. Amen. If you didn't know my daddy, you know his name. Why do you know his name?
Because you got that
name. I got that name. Being made so much better than the angels, as he hath by inheritance obtained a more excellent name than they. Thus I come. Acts 4:12 said what?
Neither
is there salvation
in any other.
For there is none other name under heaven
given
among men whereby we what?
Must
be saved. So he's got the greatest name. I think it's Ephesians. Let me get it right. No, it's Philippians 1 and 9. 2 and 9. Read, Sister Hope. 2 and 9.
Wherefore
God
also
God also
hath highly exalted
him. Highly exalted him.
And given him a name.
And given him a name.
Which is above every name.
Which is above what?
Every name.
Where did he get his name from?
His father.
And who's his father?
God.
God is the one that gave him the name. And had given him a name which is what?
Above every name.
Which is above every name. Read. That at the name of Jesus,
every knee
should bow.
Of things in heaven. And things in earth. And things under the earth.
Read.
And that every tongue
should confess.
That Jesus Christ.
Is Lord.
To the glory of God the Father,
which says Jesus is God. Back to Hebrews, being made so much better than the angel, as he hath by inheritance obtained a more excellent name than they. Read the story.
For unto which
of the angels
said he at any time, Thou art my son. This day
have I begotten thee.
And again
I will be to him a father.
And he shall be to me a son.
Now, where did this come up at?
Thank you, sir.
Pardon?
Thank you, sir.
I can't hear who it was.
Second Samuel. 7:14.
Somebody been listening?
Yes.
I read.
I just want to know who was listening. I like that.
Tracy.
Oh, Lord.
Yes.
2 Samuel what?
7:14.
He says, I will be his father, and he shall be my son. If he commit iniquity, I will chasten him with the rod of men and with the stripes of the children of men. So he's already given him his name. Going back to Hebrews, Sister Hope. Read.
And again.
When he bringeth in the first begotten
into the world,
he saith,
and let all the angels of God
worship him. So he's giving praise to the Son. Is that what he's supposed to do? Huh? I can't hear you.
I want to say yes, but I also want to say no.
He said he wouldn't give his glory to another.
Because of that verse.
And if he said he's not giving his praise, his glory to another, what's wrong with this scripture?
It sounds like he's giving it to someone else, but he's actually not.
He will not give his praise to another. He's giving his glory to another. Jesus said in John 10:30,
I and my Father
are one. One being. wrapped up in flesh. He's God. Read, Sister Hope.
And of the angels, he saith.
I think you skipped a verse.
No, verse 7.
That's right. Let all the angels. And again, when he bringeth in the first begotten into the world, he saith, let all the angels of God worship him. And of the angels, read, Sister Hope.
And of the angels he saith.
And of the angels he saith.
Who maketh his angels spirits.
Who maketh his angels spirits.
And his ministers a flame of fire.
And his ministers a flame of fire. Wait a minute. God said to the angel, who maketh his angels spirits. God did that. God created them. And he has made his ministers a flame of fire. That word is going to call somebody to live or somebody to pass away from here. Because they did or did not hear the word of the Lord. Look at Hosea 6. I'll always forget the number of that verse. Is it 6 and 5?
Yes.
6 and 5. What does it say?
Therefore have hewed them by the prophets.
Therefore have I hewed them by the prophets. I've cut them out. I cut them out by the prophets. Read.
I have slain them.
I have slain them.
By the words of my mouth.
By the words of my mouth. Because they would not hear, that he's going to slay them by the words of his mouth. But what did the words come out of?
Prophet.
It came out of the prophet's mouth.
Mm-hmm. Came out of God's mouth.
Yes, but he gave it to where?
The prophets.
See, I speak in the mic. But where's my voice coming from?
The speaker.
Coming from the speaker. Read, Sister Hope.
Where?
In Hosea. Therefore have I hewed them by the prophets.
I have slain them by the words of my mouth.
I have slain them by the words of my mouth.
And thy judgments.
And thy judgments.
As the light.
Are as the light.
That goeth forth.
That goeth forth. You got to listen to his prophets. Too many folk think they can listen to God. God don't need the prophet if he's going to talk to you. What do you need me for? If he's going to talk to you and tell you. Because what's going to happen? We're going to be such confusion. So God is not the author of confusion. Go back to Hebrews, Sister Hope.
But unto the Son he saith.
But unto the Son he saith.
Thy throne. O God.
O God. Thy throne. Now if God called him God, what is he? Thy throne, O God,
is forever and ever.
Is forever and ever. Read.
A scepter of righteousness.
A scepter of righteousness.
Is the scepter of thy kingdom.
Is the scepter of thy kingdom. It is because of who you are. Righteousness. His scepter is righteousness. Read.
Thou hast loved righteousness.
Thou hast loved righteousness.
And hated iniquity.
And hated iniquity.
Therefore God.
Therefore God.
Even thy God.
Hath anointed thee.
With the oil of gladness.
With the oil of gladness.
Above thy fellows.
Above thy fellows. Wait a minute. When did God anoint him?
Before the foundation of the world.
Where you find that?
Ephesians.
What did he anoint? What did he chose? Anointed is chosen, right?
No, not quite.
Okay.
Say again.
When the anointed, when he come up out the water from being baptized by John the Baptist, and he said, "This is my beloved son, in whom I am well pleased."
That's not when the anointing.
Okay.
Isaiah. Isaiah what?
61.
61? One.
One?
You said what?
61.
Oh. 61.
61:1,
she said.
1:27.
What does it say?
For of a truth, against thy holy child Jesus, whom thou hast anointed, both Herod and Pontius Pilate with the Gentiles and the people of Israel were gathered together.
A psalm is what I'm looking at. I gotta go back and it's either here in 132 or it's in 89 of Psalm. It's in 89
of what?
Of Psalm. Read the 19th verse of the 89th Psalm and the 20th.
Then thou speakest in vision.
Then thou spakest in vision.
To thy Holy One.
To thy Holy One.
And saidst.
And saidst.
I have laid help upon one.
I have laid help upon one.
That is mighty.
That is mighty.
I have exalted one.
I have exalted one.
Chosen out of the people.
Chosen out of the people. That's Jesus. Read.
I have found David.
I have found David.
My servant.
My servant.
With my holy oil.
With my holy oil.
Have I anointed him.
Have I anointed him. See, this for David. This, at the time that this is speaking, David the patriarch is not there. This is speaking of David, who is Jesus. This is my beloved son. Yes, ma'am.
So when is this?
This is before the birth of Jesus Christ.
This is when he was anointed.
Yes. I have found David, my servant. With my holy oil have I anointed him. David was this David that we speak of. Who is David that God anointed, not Samuel. Samuel anointed David the patriarch. But God anointed his son, which is David. the David in which he spake of. This is my beloved son. Oh, Lord, have mercy. See, you got me going back and forth. Nah, I'll be. Yes, ma'am.
Wasn't he anointed before he got here?
What was that?
He was anointed before he got here.
Yes, ma'am. By God. Is there anything? But unto the Son he saith, thy throne, O God, is forever and ever. A scepter of righteousness is the scepter of thy kingdom. Read, Sister Hope.
Thou hast loved righteousness.
Thou hast loved righteousness.
And hated iniquity. Therefore God. Even thy God. Hath anointed thee with the oil of gladness
above thy fellow. They didn't say God anointed David the patriarch. This is my David. Are y'all listening? Mm-hmm. Read, Sister Hope.
And thou, Lord.
In the beginning.
Hast laid the foundation of the earth. And the heavens. Are the works of thy hands.
Who created the heavens and the earth?
God.
Look at Colossians. One and 15, Sister Hope.
Who is the image?
Of the invisible God. That's Jesus. Am I correct? Yeah. Read.
The firstborn of every creature.
Read.
For by him,
who's that? Who was the firstborn of every creature?
Jesus.
So the scripture says, for by him, what?
Were all things created.
Read, Sister Hope.
For by him were all things created.
That are in heaven.
And that are in earth.
Visible.
And invisible.
Whether they be thrones.
Or dominions. Or principalities.
Or powers.
All things. Were created by him. And for him.
was created by him and for him. So he must be who?
God.
He's got to be God. For God did it what? All by himself.
Thank you, Jesus.
He created all things by himself. Continue in Colossians, Sister Hope.
And he is before all things. And by him. All things consist. And he is the head of the body.
He is the head of the body. Who's the head of the body?
Jesus.
What is the body?
The church.
He is the head of the body.
The church.
Thank you, Jesus.
Who is the beginning? The firstborn from the dead. that in all things,
that in all things,
he might have the preeminence.
He might have the preeminence. Read.
For it pleased the Father.
It pleased the Father.
That in him.
That in him.
Should all fullness
shall
dwell.
Shall all fullness dwell. When you talk about fullness, all the power of God is where?
In Jesus.
It's in Jesus. All the power of God. Going back to Hebrews, Sister Hope. You know where you left off?
I left off at read 9.
Track 10.
And thou, Lord.
And thou, Lord.
In the beginning.
In the beginning.
Hast laid the foundation of the earth.
Laid the foundation of the earth.
And the heavens.
And the heavens
are the works of thine hands.
Are the works of thine hand. So it's, wait a minute. It's only one doing this. It's not two. It said nothing about a trinity.
All
right. Read, Sister Hope.
They shall perish.
They shall perish.
But thou remainest.
But thou remainest.
And they shall all.
And they all shall.
Wax old.
Shall wax old.
As doth a garment.
As doth a garment. All of us, we're going to all wax old as a garment. But God, we're going to be made anew. We shall be changed. Read, Sister Hope.
And as a vesture.
And as a vesture.
Shalt thou fold them up.
Shalt thou fold them up.
And they shall be changed.
And they shall be changed.
But thou art the same.
But thou art the same.
And thy years shall not fail.
And thy years shall not end. That's what he's saying. Shall not fail. Read.
But to which of the angels?
But to which of the angels?
Said he at any time.
Said he at any time.
Sit on my right hand.
Sit on my right hand.
Until I make thine enemies.
Until I make thine enemies.
Thy footstool.
Thy footstools. He said that to the angels. The angels got to give praise to who?
God.
Read.
Are they not all ministering spirits?
Are they not all ministering spirits?
Sent forth to minister.
Sent forth to minister.
For them who shall be heirs of salvation.
For them who shall be heirs of salvation. Who they ministering to? Huh?
The saints.
Read it again so I want you to understand. Read that again, Sister Hope.
Are they not all ministering spirits?
Are they not all ministering spirits?
Sent forth.
Sent forth.
To minister.
To minister.
For them.
For them.
Who shall be heirs of salvation.
Who shall be heirs of salvation. Who are the heirs of salvation?
The church.
Y'all act y'all ain't been listening. We are the heirs of salvation. Why are we heirs? We've been baptized in his name, filled with his spirit, and we walk. My daughter is the heir of whatever I have. Amen?
Amen.
She's the heir of whatever I have. We are the heir of whatever God has.
Thank you, Jesus.
Are you listening? We are born of his spirit.
Yes, sir.
Filled with his glory. One of these days we're going to learn that. And we ain't going to be scared to acknowledge it.
Amen.
Somebody raise their hand.
Yes, sir.
Yes, ma'am.
But to which of the angels said he at any time, sit on my right hand. So he's talking about the angels at this point. And he didn't tell them. He told Jesus, sit on my right. No. Because I'm wondering, who are they not all ministering spirits?
The angels are ministering spirits. And they are ministering to the saints of God.
Through the Holy Ghost?
Through the Spirit. They are the ones watching over us. Going to and fro, wherever we go, our angels are watching over us. Sister Hope.
Doesn't it also include the pastors of the churches, of the church? Like for in
there are, the church, the pastor of the church is known as the angel of the church. Because angels are messengers. Angels are messengers. Now, these angels which we are speaking of are ministering spirits. Now, you can call the pastors spirits. 1 John. 4. Yes. 1 John 4. Read, Sister Hope. Beloved,
believe not every spirit.
Believe not every spirit. Now, is he talking about the angels that fill the atmosphere? Or the angels that walk around on 2 feet?
Yes, sir.
Believe not every spirit.
But try the spirits.
But try the spirits.
Whether they are of God.
Whether they are of God. You got to test them. Read.
Because many false prophets are gone out into the world.
Many false teachers, many false spirits, many false angels. Read.
Hereby know ye the Spirit of God.
Every spirit, every prophet, every preacher, come on now, every pastor, every spirit
that confesseth
that Jesus Christ
is come in the flesh is of God.
Now see, this threw me for a while. Because I had to read. And I had to ask. Just by reading this, I would not have come to the right conclusion. When I say just by reading this and stopping there. Hereby know ye the Spirit of God, every spirit that confesseth that Jesus Christ is come in the flesh is what?
Of God.
Is of God. Who know a preacher that does not confess Jesus Christ is come in the flesh? Who knows a preacher that does not confess that? Or who knows a preacher that does not preach that? Read, Sister Oak.
And every spirit that confesseth not that Jesus Christ
is come in the flesh.
Is not of God.
Now, how many preachers do you know don't preach that Jesus Christ is come in the flesh?
Mm-hmm.
So what you're saying is, all the preachers you know preach that Jesus come in the flesh, right? Do they really?
Those are the words that come out of their mouth.
Those are the words that come out of their mouth, that Jesus is come in the flesh. But let's see what the Bible speaks of. Fifth chapter, same book. And the 20th chapter.
21st.
20th chapter.
20th verse.
20th verse. What did I say?
Chapter.
Fifth chapter, 20th verse.
And we know.
And we know.
That the Son of God is come.
That the Son of God is come.
And hath given us.
And hath given us.
Understanding.
And understanding.
That we may know him.
That we may know him.
That is true.
That is true.
And we are in him.
And we are in him.
That is true.
That is true.
Even in his son.
Even in his son.
Jesus Christ.
Jesus Christ.
This is the true God.
This is the true God. Read.
Even eternal life.
Even eternal life. This is the true God. And eternal life. This is him. Who is that?
Jesus.
I can't hear you.
Jesus.
I can't hear you.
Jesus.
This is the true God. So how many of you hear them preach that Jesus is the true God? You hear him preach that Jesus is the Son of God. And that's the limit that they will go. But they're not of God. Those spirits are not of God. Isaiah. I'm almost finished. I'm about ready to quit. 9 and 6.
For unto us,
a child is born.
Unto us. A son is given.
A son is given.
And the government.
Shall be upon his shoulders.
Shoulder. And his name. Shall be called Wonderful. Counselor.
The Mighty God.
Woo.
The Mighty God.
The Everlasting Father.
Come on. Oh, have mercy, Lord. Come on now. The baby going to be called the Everlasting Father. Yes,
the Prince of Peace.
He's going to be called the Prince of Peace.
Hallelujah.
He's that all by himself.
Yes,
what did 40 and 5 of Psalm say? Lo, I come in the volume of the book. It is written of me. It ain't written of David the patriarch. It's not written of Samuel and Ezekiel. It's not written of Jeremiah and
Daniel.
It's not written of any of the prophets. Is written of Jesus. Is written of God. Are there any questions? Thank you, Jesus. Come on, Sister Holloway. See, I'm going to let you go home early.
Amen.
Sister Holloway, be slow. Y'all might be here tonight.
Amen. Come on, put your hands together and give God some praise. Amen. Amen. As we look across the congregation, it seems all has been baptized in Jesus' name. But there may be one on the outside of the door tonight that heard the word of God and want to be saved. We have water, we have clothing, and we have someone to baptize in the name of Jesus. For it's the only name under heaven given among men whereby we must be saved. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. We see that there's none coming.